Hello there. Here we are again. This is your Uncle Don. That's right, now we're going to sing some more songs. I'm going to sing about old King Cole. Like that one? All right, here we go. Old King Cole was a merry old soul, and a merry old soul was he. He called for his pipe, and he called for his bowl, and he called for his fiddlers three. Oh, every fiddler, he had a fiddle, and a very fine fiddle had he. Oh, there's none so rare as can compare with King Cole and his fiddlers three. And now the little old woman, know that one?
All right, it is then.
There was a little woman, I've been told, ah me, diddle diddle dee. She wasn't very young and she wasn't very old, ah me, diddle diddle dee. She went to market on a market day, ah me, diddle diddle dee. She fell asleep on the king's highway, ah me, diddle diddle dee. And here's one I'll bet you all know. Now you sing this one with me. Oh, do you know the Muffin Man, the Muffin Man, the Muffin Man? Do you know the Muffin Man who lives in Drury Lane? Oh, yes, I know the Muffin Man, the Muffin Man, the Muffin Man. Yes, I know the Muffin Man who lives in Drury Lane. And here's one where you clap hands, you know, bean porridge hot. All right, let's do that one. Bean porridge hot, bean porridge cold, bean porridge in the pot 9 days old. Some like it hot, some like it cold, some like it in the pot 9 days old. And now a little ABC song. Now you better do this one with me too, so you'll learn the alphabet. Ready? Here we are then. Oh, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, N, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Now, how about the three blind mice? This is a rondelay. Oh, three blind mice, three blind mice. See how they run, see how they run. They all ran after the farmer's wife who cut off their tail with a carving knife. Did you ever see such a sight in your life? A three blind mice. And now, old Mother Hubbard. Old Mother Hubbard, she went to the cupboard to get her poor doggy a bone. And when she came there, the cupboard was bare, and so the poor doggy had none. She went to the fishman to buy him some fish. When she came back, he was licking the dish. She made a curtsy, the dog made a bow, and she said, I'm your servant. The dog said, ah, ah.
It's not easy, so you gotta know how to treat me. Easy gonna be all about you and me, baby. Open up your heart, don't be afraid. My love ain't going no place.
Here we go again. Yeah, this is your Uncle Don. And we're going to have some songs now, some more songs. Especially, oh, the one about the little pig went to market. You know that one? Well, let's try it. This little pig went to market. This little pig stayed home. This little pig got roast beef. and this little pig had none. This little pig cried wee, 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 wee all the way home. That's a nice one to play with baby, isn't it? And oh, here's one I bet you know. Oh, pat a cake, baker's man. So I will master as fast as I can. Pat it and pick it and mark it with T and toss it in the oven for Tommy and me. And here's one I always liked too. There was a little girl. Oh, there was a little girl and she had a little curl right in the middle of her forehead. And when she was good, she was very, very good. When she was bad, she was horrid. She stood on her head in her little trundle bed with nobody by for to hinder. She screamed and she squalled and she yelled and she bawled and she drummed her little heels against the winder. Her mother heard the noise and thought it was the boys playing in the empty attic. She rushed upstairs and she caught her unawares and she spanked her most emphatic. And now about little pussy. I love little pussy. I love little pussy, her coat is so warm. If I don't hurt her, she'll do me no harm. So I'll not pull her tail or drive her away. But pussy and I very gently will play. She'll sit by my side and I'll give her her food. And she'll like me because I am gentle and good. And now, Goosey Goosey Gander, you know that one? Goosey, goosey gander, where shall I wander? Upstairs or downstairs or in my lady's chamber? There I met an old man who would not say his prayers. I took him by the left leg and I threw him down the stairs. And now, 10 Little Indians. You know that one? Oh, 10 little Indians standing in the line. One went home and then there were 9 little Indians swinging on the gate. One jumped off and then there were 8 little Indians staying at a tavern. One went away and then there were 7 little Indians playing pretty tricks. One went to ride and then there were 6 little Indians learning how to dive. One swam away and then there were 5 little Indians peeped through the door. One ran behind and then there were 4 little Indians climbed up a tree. One slid down and then there were 3 little Indians out in a canoe. One hopped to land and then there were 2 little Indians playing in the sun. One fell asleep and then there was 1 little Indian playing all alone. He went in the house and then there was none. Hello. Well, this is your Uncle Don. Yes, and we're going to sing some more songs. Let's start out with the Queen of Hearts. You know that one? Okay, here's the way it goes. Well, the Queen of Hearts, she made some tarts all on a summer's day. And the Knave of Hearts, he stole the tarts and he took them clean away. And the King of Hearts called for the tarts and he beat the Knave full sore. And the Knave of Hearts brought back the tarts and he vowed he'd steal no more. I don't blame him. I wouldn't either, would you? No, sir. See, here's a little song about I love sixpence. Well, that means 6 pennies, you know. And here's the way it goes. I love a sixpence, pretty little sixpence. I love a sixpence better than my life. I spent a penny of it, I spent another. And I took 4 pence home to my wife. Oh, my little 4 pence, pretty little 4 pence. I love 4 pence better than my life. I spent a penny of it, I spent another. And I took 2 pence home to my wife. Oh, my little 2 pence, pretty little 2 pence. I love 2 pence better than my life. I spent a penny of it, I spent another. And I took nothing home to my wife. Oh, my little nothing, my pretty little nothing. What will nothing buy for my wife? I have nothing, I spend nothing. I love nothing better than my wife. Oh, dear, and here's a song about vegetables. Oh, I think you're going to like this one. And I want you to be sure and learn the chorus so you can sing it with me. Here's the way it goes. Oh, Charlie Carrot is a very charming little man. He wears a little green cap and overalls of tan. He looks so kind and tender, and he tastes so good and sweet. I'd say he is a dandy food to eat. Hooray, hooray, the vegetables, what fun. Hooray, hooray, we'll eat them every one. They'll keep our cheeks so rosy and they'll make our engines run. If we will eat them every day. Susie Squash and Billy Beet, as red as any rose. Onions, turnips, parsnips, and the lovely Tommy Toes. Cauliflower, spinach, green potatoes, beans and peas. Come, let us make friends with all of these. Now the chorus. Hooray, hooray, the vegetables, what fun. Hooray, hooray, we'll eat them every one. They'll keep our cheeks so rosy and they'll make our engines run. If we will eat them every day.
There. This is your Uncle Don. Yes, sir, and here's some more songs, and we're going to start with a song called For Want of a Nail. For want of a nail, the shoe was lost. For want of a shoe, the horse was lost. For want of a horse, the rider was lost. And for want of a rider, the battle was lost. For want of the battle, the kingdom was lost. And all for the want of a horseshoe nail. And now the little song about Solomon Grundy. You know that one? Oh, Solomon Grundy, born on a Monday, christened on a Tuesday, married on a Wednesday, sick on a Thursday, worse on a Friday, died on a Saturday, buried on a Sunday. Oh, this is the end of Solomon Grundy, way down there in the cellar. And now, about a week of birthdays. Oh, Monday's child is fair of face. Tuesday's child is full of grace. And Wednesday's child is full of woe. Thursday's child has far to go. Friday's child is loving and giving. Saturday's child works hard for a living. But the child that's born on a Sabbath day is blithe and bonny and good and gay. And here's one mother used to sing to me about the little man and the gun. Oh, there was a little man, and he had a little gun, and his bullets were made of lead, lead, lead. He went to a brook, and he saw a little duck, and he shot it right through the head, head, head. He carried it home to his good wife, Joan, and told her a fire to make, 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 to roast the little duck he had shot in the brook, and he'd go and fetch the drake, drake, drake. Well, the drake was a-swimming with his little curly tail. The little man made it his mark, mark, mark. shot off the gun, but he fired too soon, and away flew the drake with a quack, quack, quack.
Then the song about the two cats of Kilkenny.
Well, there once were two cats of Kilkenny, and each thought there was one cat too many. So they fought and they fit and they scratched and they bit, till excepting their nails and the tips of their tails, instead of two cats there weren't any.
And here's a new one, and I want you to learn all the words to this if you can.
Oh, now a song I'm going to sing about a funny little king. He is the boss of everything that lives on the Cannibal Island. His name is Hokey Pokey Winky Wum, Polly Magoo, Kingery Kung, Hangery Wangery Chingery Chung, the king of the Cannibal Island. He wears but few and scanty clothes. He wears a ring right through his nose, and he wears rings on his ears and toes, the king of the Cannibal Island. Hokey Pokey Winky Wum, Polly Magoo, Kingery Kung, Hangery Wangery Chingery Chung, the king of the Cannibal Island.
I remember when I was an innocent child at the early age of 10. I couldn't wait for a single thing. When I wanted it then. And I remember my mama telling me, a catch you little phrase. She said, you may not know the meaning right now, but someday it's gonna win the praise. She told me that.
come here today. Oh, of course you must poo poo whatever may be fresh and new. I declare it crude and mean. For art stops short in the cultivated court of the Empress Josephine. And everyone will say, as you walk your mystic way, if that's not good enough for him, which is good enough for me. Oh, I have a very cultivated kind of you, this kind of you. But
for my man, but you gotta take it slow. I've been there before, so I know it's not easy.
Hello there. How are you? Well, this is your Uncle Don. That's right, and we're going to have some fun, too. Tell you what let's do. Let's have some song games. Like the Farmer in the Dell, you know? You know that one? Oh, fine. Let's sing the Farmer in the Dell, then. Here we go.
The Farmer in the Dell, the Farmer in the Dell. Hi-yo, the derry-o, the Farmer in the Dell. The Farmer takes a wife, the Farmer takes a wife. Hi-yo, the derry-o, the Farmer takes a wife. And the wife takes a child, the wife takes a child. Hi-yo, the derry-o, the wife takes a child. And the child takes a nurse, the child takes a nurse. Hi-yo, the derry-o, the child takes a nurse. And the nurse takes the cat, the nurse takes the cat. Hi-yo, the derry-o, the nurse takes the cat. And the cat takes the rat, the cat takes the rat. Hi-yo, the derry-o, cat takes the rat. And the rat takes the cheese, the rat takes the cheese. Hi-yo, the derry-o, the rat takes the cheese. And the cheese stands alone, the cheese stands alone. Hi-ho, the derry-o, the cheese stands alone.
I like that one. Oh, say, do you know another one called Oats, Peas, Beans, and Barley Grow? Well, let's get all set for that one, then. We'll do that one next. Here we go.
Oats, peas, beans, and barley grow. Oats, peas, beans, and barley grow. Can you or I or anyone know? Oats, peas, beans, and barley grow. Waiting for a partner. Waiting for a partner. Open the ring and bring one in while we gaily dance and sing. Here's the farmer sowing seeds. Thus he stands and takes his ease. Stamping his foot and clapping his hand. Turns around and views his lands. Tra-la-la-la-la-la. Tra-la-la-la-la-la. Stamping his foot and clapping his hands. He turns around and views his lands. And now how about London Bridge?
You do that one? All right, here we go then.
Oh, London Bridge is falling down, falling down, falling down. London Bridge is falling down, my fair lady. Oh, build it up with bricks and stone, bricks and stone, bricks and stone. Build it up with bricks and stone, my fair lady. Build it up with iron bars, iron bars, iron bars. Build it up with iron bars, my fair lady. Off to prison you must go, you must go, you must go. Off to prison you must go, my fair lady. Oh, take the key and lock her up, lock her up, lock her up. Take the key and lock her up, my fair lady.
Hello there, this is Uncle Don. Feel like playing some games now? Song games? All right, how's about Here We Go Round the Mulberry Bush? You know that one?
Oh, fine then, let's do it.
Here we go then.
Oh, here we go round the mulberry bush, the mulberry bush, the mulberry bush. Here we go round the mulberry bush so early in the morning. This is the way we wash our clothes, wash our clothes, wash our clothes. This is the way we wash our clothes so early Monday morning. This is the way we iron our clothes, iron our clothes, iron our clothes. This is the way we iron our clothes so early Tuesday morning. This is the way we scrub the floor, scrub the floor, scrub the floor. This is the way we scrub the floor so early Wednesday morning. This is the way we mend our clothes, we mend our clothes. This is the way we mend our clothes so early Thursday morning. This is the way we sweep the floor, sweep the floor, sweep the floor. This is the way we sweep the floor so early Friday morning. This is the way we bake our bread, we bake our bread. This is the way we bake our bread so early Saturday morning. This is the way we go to church, go to church, go to church. This is the way we go to church so early Sunday morning.
Oh, that was fine. You know that one real well. How about Tisket a Tasket? Know that one? All right, let's do that one then.
A tisket, a tasket, a green and yellow basket. I wrote a letter to my aunt, and on the way I dropped it. I dropped it, I dropped it, and on the way I dropped it. I wrote a letter to my aunt, and on the way I lost it.
Then you have to run around and catch the other one. Oh, that's fun. I used to like to play that one. Oh, say, how about Ring Around the Rosie? Oh, that's a good one. I bet you know that one, too. All right, let's do Ring Around a Rosie.
Ring around a rosie, pocket full of posies. Ashes, ashes, all fall down. Ring around the roses, pick the pretty posies. Boys and girls now, all fall down. Ring around the roses, smell the pretty posies. One, two, all fall down.
How about Pop Goes the Weasel? You know that one?
Oh, all around the cobbler's bench, the monkey chased the weasel. The monkey thought it was all in fun. Goes the weasel. Penny for a spool of thread, a penny for a needle. That's the way the money goes. Goes the weasel. All around the cobbler's bench, the monkey chased the weasel. Monkey jumped upon the bench. Goes the weasel.
Hey, so you gotta know how to treat me. Easy gonna be all about you and me. Open up your heart, don't be afraid. My love ain't going no place.
Thank you. am I alone and unobserved? I am. Then let me own I'm an aesthetic sham. This air severe is but a mere veneer. This cynic smile is but a wile of guile. This costume chaste is but good taste misplaced. Let me confess, a languid love for lilies does not blight me. Lank limbs and haggard cheeks do not delight me. I do not care for dirty greens by any means. I do not long for all one sees that's Japanese. I am not fond of uttering platitudes in stained glass attitudes. In short, my medievalism's affectation, born of a morbid love of admiration. If you're anxious for to shine in the high aesthetic line as a man of culture, you must get up all the germs of the transcendental terms and plant them everywhere. You must lie upon the daisies and discourse in novel phrases of your complicated state of mind. The meaning doesn't matter if it's only idle chatter of a transcendental kind. And everyone will say, as you walk your mystic way, if this young man expresses himself in terms too deep for me, why, what a very singularly deep young man this deep young man must be. Eloquent in praise of the very dull old days which have long since passed away, and convince them, if you can, that the reign of good Queen Anne was culture's palmiest day. Of course you will poo-poo whatever's fresh and new and declare it's crude and mean, for art stopped short in the cultivated court of the Empress Josephine. And everyone will say, as you walk your mystic way, if that's not good enough for him, which is good enough for me, why, what a very cultivated kind of youth this kind of youth must be. Then a sentimental passion of a vegetable fashion must excite your languid spleen. An attachment a la Plato for a bashful young potato or a not too French French bean. Though the Philistines may jostle, you will rank as an apostle in the high aesthetic band if you walk down Piccadilly with a poppy or a lily in your medieval hand. And everyone will say, as you walk your flowery way, if he's content with a vegetable love, which would certainly not suit me, why, what a most particularly pure young man this pure young man must be.
Thank you.
Hello there. This is Uncle Don. And let's sing some songs, shall we? Let's sing about There Was a Man in Our Town. I'll bet you know that one. Here it is. There was a man in our town, and he was wondrous wise. He jumped into a bramble bush, scratched out both his eyes. Now when he saw his eyes were out, with all his might and main, he jumped into another bush, and he scratched them in again. Imagine, how could he see his eyes were out? Oh, see, here's a little song about Punch and Judy. Punch and Judy fought for a pie. Punch gave Judy a knock in the eye. Said Punch to Judy, will you have any more? Said Judy to Punch, no, my eyes are too sore. And the song about This is the House That Jack Built. Oh, that's a humdinger. Maybe you can sing this one with me, too. Now, this is the house that Jack built. And this is the malt that lay in the house that Jack built. This is the rat that ate the malt that lay in the house that Jack built. And this is the cat that killed the rat that ate the malt that lay in the house that Jack built. And this is the dog that worried the cat that killed the rat that ate the malt that lay in the house that Jack built. This is the cow with the crumpled horn that tossed the dog that worried the cat that killed the rat that ate the malt that lay in the house that Jack built. And this is the maiden all forlorn that milked the cow with the crumpled horn that tossed the dog that worried the cat that killed the rat that ate the malt that lay in the house that Jack built. This is the man all tattered and torn that kissed the maiden all forlorn that milked the cow with the crumpled horn that tossed the dog that worried the cat that killed the rat that ate the malt that lay in the house that Jack built. I told you it took a lot of wind. This is the priest all shaven and shorn that married the man all tattered and torn that kissed the maiden all forlorn that milked the cow with a crumpled horn that tossed the dog that worried the cat that killed the rat that ate the malt that lay in the house that Jack built. And this is the cock that crowed in the morn that waked the priest all shaven and shorn that married the man all tattered and torn that kissed the maiden all forlorn that milked the cow with a crumpled horn that tossed the dog that worried the cat that killed the rat that ate the malt that lay in the house that Jack built. And this is the farmer sowing his corn that kept the cock that crowed in the morn that waked the priest all shaven and shorn that married the man all tattered and torn that kissed the maiden all forlorn that milked the cow with a crumpled horn that tossed the dog that worried the cat that killed the rat that ate the malt that lay in the house that Jack built.
It's time now for the hour of truth. Miguel, 3 years old, they're going to take the bull away, the bull he loves, the bull he raised.
Look, I'm the way going to kill the bull. I love him. Nach my bull, nach you bull, you fink.
Ah, my song.
Don't call me your song. I'm nach your song. Nach you kill my muer, you stick the bandolier on him.
Hello, this is your Uncle Don. Yes, and we have some more songs, too. Oh, boy, we got a lot of songs. Let's sing the one about the clever hen.
I had a little hen, the prettiest ever seen. She washed me the dishes and kept the whole house clean. She went to the mill just to fetch me some flour, and she brought it home again in less than an hour. She baked me my bread, and then she brewed my ale. She sat down by the fire and told many a fine tale.
I'd like to have a little hen like that, wouldn't you? And here's a good one. Come out to play.
Oh, boys and girls, come out to play at the closing of the day. Before the sun has gone to sleep, come with your playmates into the street. Come with a whistle, come with a call, come with a goodwill or not at all. Up the ladder and down the wall, a halfpenny roll will serve us all. So you find the milk and I'll find the flour, and we'll have a pudding in a half an hour.
And here's a very nice little song about Baby Dolly.
Hush, baby, my dolly, I pray you don't cry. I'll give you some bread and some milk by and by. Or perhaps you like custard, or maybe a tart. Then to either you're welcome with all of my heart. Mm-hmm. And then there's a little song about the boy and the sparrow. Well, a little cock sparrow sat on a tree. He chirped and he chirped, so merry was he. A naughty boy came with his wee bow and arrow, determined to shoot the little cock sparrow. This little cock sparrow shall make me a stew, and his giblets shall make me a little pie, too. Oh, no, said the sparrow, I won't make a stew. So he flapped his wings, and away he flew. Just like that. And here's one about one I love, two I love. Well, I bet you know that one. Oh, one I love, two I love, three I love, I say. And four I love with all my heart, five I cast away. Six he loves, seven she loves, eight they both love so. Nine he comes, 10 he tarries, 11 he courts, and 12 he marries. Mm-hmm. Then a little song about ride away. I like this one too. Ride away, Johnny shall ride. He'll have a pussy cat tied to one side. He'll have a puppy dog tied to the other, and he shall ride home again, back to his mother. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
unobserved, I am. Then let me own, I'm an aesthetic sham. This air severe is but a mere veneer. This cynic smile is but a wile of guile. This costume chaste is but good taste misplaced. Let me confess, a languid love for lilies does not blight me. Lank limbs and haggard cheeks do not delight me. I do not care for dirty greens by any means. I do not long for all one sees that's Japanese. I am not fond of uttering platitudes in stained glass attitudes. In short, my medievalism's affectation, born of a morbid love of admiration. If you're anxious for to shine in the high aesthetic line as a man of culture rare, you must get up all the germs of the transcendental terms and plant them everywhere. You must lie upon the daisies and discourse in novel phrases of your complicated state of mind. The meaning doesn't matter if it's only idle chatter of a transcendental kind. And everyone will say, as you walk your mystic way, if this young man expresses himself in terms too deep for me, why, what a very singularly deep young man this deep young man must be. Be eloquent in praise of the very dull old days which have long since passed away, and convince them, if you can, that the reign of good Queen Anne was culture's palmiest day. Of course you will poo-poo whatever's fresh and new and declare it's crude and mean, for art stopped short in the cultivated court of the Empress Josephine. And everyone will say, as you walk your mystic way, if that's not good enough for him, which is good enough for me, why, what a very cultivated kind of youth this kind of youth must be. Then a sentimental passion of a vegetable fashion must excite your languid spleen. An attachment a la Plato for a bashful young potato or a not too French French bean. Though the Philistines may jostle, you will rank as an apostle in the high aesthetic band if you walk down Piccadilly with a poppy or a lily in your medieval hand. And everyone will say, as you walk your flowery way, if he's content with a vegetable love, which would certainly not suit me, why, what a most particularly pure young man this pure young man must be.
Thank you. everything has gone wrong with me since that smug-faced idiot came here. Before that, I was admired. I may say loved.
Too mild. Adored.
Do let a poet soliloquize. The damosels used to follow me wherever I went. Now they all follow him.
Not all. I am still faithful to you.
Yes, and a pretty damosel you are.
No, not pretty. Massive. Cheer up. Oh. I will never leave you. I swear it.
Oh, thank you. I know what it is. It's his confounded mildness. They find me too highly spiced, if you please. And no doubt I am highly spiced.
Not for my taste.
No, but I am for theirs. But I will show the world that I can be as mild as he. If they want insipidity, they shall have it. I'll meet this fellow on his own ground and beat him on it.
You shall, and I will help you.
You will? Jane, there's a good deal of good in you after all.
Compliment a romical.
Say hey to you, good day to you, and that's what I shall say.
Your style is much too sanctified, your cut is too canonical.
Say hard you, ha-ha to you, and that's what I shall say.
I was the beau ideal of the morbid young aesthetical. To doubt my inspiration was regarded as heretical. Until you cut me out with your placidity vertical.
Sing boo to you, poo-poo to you, and that's what I shall say. Sing boo to you, poo-poo to you, and that's what I shall say.
Sing hey to you, good day to you, sing boo to you, ha-ha.
I'll tell him that unless he will consent to be more jocular.
See, boo to you, poo-poo to you, and that's what you should say.
To cut his curly hair and stick an eyeglass in his ocular.
Sing boo to you, ho-ho to you, and that's what you should say.
To stuff his conversation full of quibble and of quiddity. To dine on chops and roly-poly pudding with avidity. It better tear away with all convenient rapidity.
Sing hey to you, good day to you, and that's what you should say.
Sing boo to you, poo-poo to you, and that's what I shall say.
Sing hey to you, good day to you, sing boo to you, ha-ha to you, sing boo to you, poo-poo to you, and that's what you should say. Sing hey to you, good day to you, sing boo to you, ha-ha to you, sing boo to you,
and that's what I should say.
Boo, boo,
boo, and that's what I should say. Ba,
boo,
ba,
boo,
and that's what I should say.
Something like this sort of thing. this. You hold yourself like that. By hook and crook, you try to look both angular and flat. To cultivate the trim, rigidity of limb, you ought to get a marionette and form your style on him.
Yes, it's quite clear that our only chance of making a lasting impression on these young ladies is to become as aesthetic as they are.
No doubt. The only question is how far we succeeded in doing so. I don't know why, but I've an idea that this is not quite right.
I don't like it. I never did. I don't see what it means. I do it, but I don't like it.
My good friend, the question is not whether we like it, but whether they do. They understand these things. We don't. Now, I shouldn't be surprised if this is effective enough at a distance.
I can't help thinking we're a little stiff at it. It would be extremely awkward if we were to be struck so.
I don't think we shall be struck so. Perhaps we're a little awkward at first. But everything must have a beginning. Oh, here they come. Tennyson!
Oh, Sapphire, see. The immortal fire has descended on them. And they are of the inner brotherhood, perceptibly intense and consummately utter.
How Botticellian, how Fra Angelican. Oh, art, we thank thee for this boon.
I'm afraid we're not quite right.
Not supremely, perhaps, but oh, so all but. Oh, Sapphire, are they not quite too all but?
They are indeed jolly utter.
I wonder what the inner brotherhood usually recommend for cramp.
Ladies, we will not deceive you. We are doing this at some personal inconvenience with a view of expressing the extremity of our devotion to you. We trust that it is not without its effect.
We will not deny that we are much moved by this proof of your attachment.
Yes, your conversion to the principles of aesthetic art in its highest development has touched us deeply.
And if Mr. Grosvenor should remain obdurate,
which we have every reason to believe he will...
Oh, I wish they'd make haste.
We are not prepared to say that our yearning hearts will not go out to you.
By six and for threes, rapture.
Oh, it's extremely good. For beginners, it's admirable.
The only question is, who will take who?
Oh, the Duke chooses first as a matter of course.
Oh, I couldn't think of it. You're really too good.
Nothing of the kind. You are a great matrimonial fish, and it's only fair that each of these ladies should have a chance of hooking you.
If Sapphire I choose to marry, I shall be fixed up for life. Then the colonel need not tarry, Angela can be his wife.
In that case, I'm president, a single I shall live and die. I shall have to be contented with a heartfelt sympathy.
He will have to be contented with a heartfelt sympathy. In that case, I'm president, a single I shall live and die. I shall have to be contented with a heart of sympathy.
He will have to be contented with a heart of sympathy. He will have to be contented with a heart of sympathy.
Angie, I determine at my wedding she'll appear, decking diamond on army major, then can take Sapphire.
In the case of president, it's single, I shall live and die. I shall have to be contented with a heartfelt sympathy.
I shall have to be contented with a heartfelt sympathy. In the case of president, it's single, I shall live and die. I shall have to be contented with a heartfelt sympathy.
I shall have to be contented with a heartfelt sympathy. I shall have to be contented with a heartfelt sympathy.
After some debate,
it eternal if on either I decide. Sapphire then can take the colonel and she be the major's bride. In that case of precedented single, I must live and die. I shall have to be contented with their heartfelt sympathy.
You have to be contented with their heartfelt sympathy. In the case of precedented single, I shall live and die. I shall have to be contented with their heartfelt sympathy. I shall have to be contented with their heartfelt sympathy. I shall have to be contented with their heartfelt.
It is very pleasant to be alone. It is pleasant to be able to gaze at leisure upon those features which all others may gaze upon at their goodwill. Ah, I am a very narcissist.
It's no use. I can't live without admiration. Since Grosvenor came here, insipidity has been at a premium. Ah, he's there.
Ah, Bunthorne! Come here. Look. Very graceful, isn't it?
Allow me. I haven't seen it.
Yes, it is. Graceful.
Oh, good gracious, not that. This.
You don't mean that. Bah! I'm in no mood for trifling.
And what is amiss?
Ever since you came here, you have entirely monopolized the attentions of the young ladies. I don't like it, sir.
My dear sir, how can I help it? They are the plague of my life. My dear Mr. Bunthorne, with your personal disadvantages, you can have no idea of the inconvenience of being madly loved at first sight by every woman you meet.
Sir, until you came here, I was adored.
Exactly, until I came here, that's my grievance. I cut everybody out. Oh. I assure you, if you could only suggest some means whereby, consistently with my duty to society, I could escape these inconvenient attentions, you would earn my everlasting gratitude.
I will do so at once. However popular it may be with the world at large, your personal appearance is highly objectionable to me.
It is? Oh, thank you, thank you. How can I express my gratitude?
By making a complete change at once. Your conversation must henceforth be perfectly matter-of-fact. You must cut your hair and have a back parting.
Beg pardon?
A back parting, sir. In appearance and costume, you must be absolutely commonplace.
No, pardon me. That's impossible.
Take care. When I am thwarted, I am very terrible.
I can't help that. I am a man with a mission, and that mission must be fulfilled.
I don't think you quite appreciate the consequences of thwarting me.
I don't care what they are.
Suppose. I won't go so far as to say that I will do it. But suppose for one moment I were to curse you. Very well. Take care, take care.
But surely you would never do that.
I don't know. It would be an extreme measure, no doubt, but still.
But you would not do it. I'm sure you would not. Oh, reflect, reflect. You had a mother once.
Never!
Then you had an aunt. I see you had. By the memory of that aunt, I implore you to pause ere you resort to this last fearful expedient. Oh, Mr. Bunthorne, reflect, reflect!
I must not allow myself to be unmanned. It is useless. Consent at once, or may a nephew's curse...
Hold! Are you absolutely resolved?
Absolutely.
Will nothing shake you?
Nothing. I am adamant.
Very good. Then I yield.
Ah, you swear it?
I do cheerfully. I have long wished for a reasonable pretext for such a change as you suggest. It has come at last. I do it on compulsion.
Victory! I triumph! When I go out of door of damosels a score, or sang and burning and clinging, and yet he will follow me as before. I shall with cultured taste distinguished gems from paste, and high little diddle would rank as a niddle if I pronounced it chaste.
A most intense young man, a soulful mind young man, an ultra poetical, super aesthetical, out of the way young man. Conceive me if you can, an everyday young man, a commonplace type with a stick and a pipe and a harp, a black and tan, who thinks suburban hops more fun than Monday pops, who's fond of his dinner and doesn't get thinner on bottled beer and chops.
A commonplace young man, a matter-of-fact young man, a steady and stolidly jolly bank holiday everyday young man. A Japanese young man, a blue and white young man, Francesco Rimini, Mimini, Pimini, Je ne sais quoi young man.
A Chancery Lane young man, a Somerset House young man, a very delectable, highly respectable, threepenny bus young man.
A pallid and thin young man, a haggard and lank young man, a greenery gallery, grove and a gallery, foot in the grave young man.
A Sewell and Cross young man, a Howell and James young man, a pushing young particle, what's an eighth article, Waterloo House young man. Conceive me if you can, a matter of fact young man, an alphabetical hair is medical everyday young man. Conceive me if you can, a matter of fact young man, an alphabetical hair is medical everyday young man.
It is all right. I have committed my last act of ill nature, and henceforth I'm a changed character. La 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 dee.
Reginald, dancing? And what in the world is the matter with you?
Patience. I'm a changed man. Hitherto I've been gloomy, moody, fitful, uncertain in temper, and selfish in disposition.
You have indeed.
All that is changed. I have reformed. I have modeled myself upon Mr. Grosvenor. Henceforth, I am mildly cheerful. My conversation will blend amusement with instruction. I shall still be aesthetic, but my aestheticism will be of the most pastoral kind.
Oh, Reginald, is all this true?
Oh, quite true. Observe how amiable I am.
But, Reginald, how long will this last?
With occasional intervals for rest and refreshment, as long as I do.
Oh, Reginald, I'm so happy. Oh, dear, dear Reginald, I cannot express the joy I feel at this change. It will no longer be a duty to love you, but a pleasure, a rapture, an ecstasy.
My darling.
But, oh horror!
What's the matter?
Is it quite certain that you have absolutely reformed? That you are henceforth a perfect being, utterly free from defect of any kind?
It is quite certain. I have sworn it.
Silver is the loving crop of scissors and needles, nails and knives, offering love for all their lives. But for I, the magnet, felt no whim. Though he charmed I, did charm not him. From needles and nails and knives he turned, for he set his love on a silver charm.
A silver charm.
A silver charm. His best aesthetic, very magnetic, fancy talk this tone. If I can wheedle a knife or a needle, why not a silver charm?
His most aesthetic, very magnetic, fancy talk this tone. If I can wheedle a knife or a needle, why not a silver charm?
Steel express surprise. The needles open their well-drilled eyes. The penknives felt shot up, no doubt. The scissors declare themselves cut out. The kettles they boil with rage disturbed, while every nail went off its head, and hither and thither began to roam, till a hammer came up and rolled them home.
Drove
them home. While this magnetic, peripatetic lover he lived alone. By no endeavor can magnet ever attract a silver charm.
While this magnetic, peripatetic lover he lived alone. By no endeavor can magnet.
Love that you're wrong.
him and say to him with compliment ironical,
sing hey to you, good day to you, and that's what I should say.
Your style is much too sanctified, your cut is too canonical.
Sing ba to you, ha ha to you, and that's what I should say.
I was the beau ideal of the morbid young aesthetical, who doubt my inspiration was regarded as heretical, until you cut me out with your placidity and vertical.
Sing hey to you, good day to you, and that's what I shall say. Sing boo to you, poo poo to you, and that's what I shall say.
Sing hey, hey to you, good day to you,
good
sing
day
to you, ha ha to you, poo poo to you, poo poo to you, and that's what I shall say. Sing hey to you, good day to you, sing boo to you, ha ha to you, poo poo to you,
and that's what I shall say. Boo, boo, and that's what I shall say. Ba, ba, and that's what I shall say. I'll tell him that unless he will consent to be more jocular,
sing boo to you, poo poo to you, and that's what you should say.
To cut his curly hair and stick an eyeglass in his ocular,
sing ba to you, ha ha to you, and that's what you should say.
To stuff his conversation full of quibble and of quiddity, to dine on chops and roly-poly pudding with avidity, he'd better clear the way with all convenient rapidity.
Sing hey to you, good day to you, and that's what you should say.
Sing boo to you, poo poo to you, and that's what I should say.
Sing hey to you, good day to you,
good
sing
day
to you, ha ha to you, ha ha to you, ha ha to you, ha ha to you, sing hey to you, good day to you, sing ha to you, ha ha to you, ha ha to you,
and that's what I shall say. Boo, 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 and that's what I shall say. Ba, boo, ba, boo, and that's what I
expect